Welcome back to Houston, everybody. It is time to start a new season here. I believe this is year number 5, and to my surprise, you guys want me to get rid of Hellebuck. I thought he was going to be our guy, but I guess he is 32, making $9 million a year. So, yeah, that's a thing. And Robert Thomas, I kind of feel bad for this guy, but he's probably going to get stuck on the third line again. Anyway, let's try to make some moves here. Because there are some players I want to get rid of. Some you might be upset about. Some maybe not. Well, there's only a couple players I really want to move. And also, I want to bring Roslovic back up just in case. So let's go to roster moves. He might actually fit in with the team. And in the system, Roslovic. Where is he? Oh, he's down to 77. Yeah, he'll probably spike back up when I call him up. So, yeah, he's still listed as a third line. Boom, bring him up. And let's go to the NHL. Did he get bumped up at all? Roslovic, or is he still down? Okay, he's still at 77. That's okay. And I will edit the AHL lines for now. Just toss someone in there temporarily. Scratched. And I guess we'll throw in Wilson. Sure, there you go. Substitute in all lines. Move Dal Cole up. There you have it. All right. Yeah, the AHL team looking solid. We will play Suzuki in the AHL one more year. And Teal is going to be coming up, but... yeah, let's make some trades. Okay, so I got two in mind here, and hopefully you agree with them. So the first one is going to be JT Miller. Yep, sorry. 7.8 million and 3 years left when he's already 32. He's only going downhill from here. Sorry, JT, but we are going our separate ways. But what we're bringing in is going to be a Detroit Red Wing, who is on the block, and it's going to be Lucas Raymond. So he's making 8.7 for 5 years, but yeah, this guy's going to be unbelievable. He's only 23, so I think this is a good deal because we're giving them a player on a better contract that's older. So, you know, we're basically allowing them to try and win now, and then we're taking Lucas Raymond off their hands, who is a prospect, but an insane prospect. He's 83 overall. He's probably going to spike up when we trade for him, and he's listed as a first line forward. Okay, so yeah, let's do it. Proposed trade accepted. Okay, so there we go, and let's just do best roster for now. Okay, and I'm sorry you lost morale, Hellebuck, but you're still going. Connor Hellebuck, there he is. Okay, 91 overall. He still has pretty good trade value, and there was a defenseman that I had in mind to pick up for Connor Hellebuck. Now let me just try to remember who it was. All right, I remembered. It was Miro Heiskanen. So he is currently on an $8.5 million contract, which is quite a lot. But he is an 89 overall defenseman who's only 26, and he has 4 abilities. He's listed as a top 2 defender, and we're getting a medium top 6 forward here. So could pan out, could not. But it's maybe worth the risk. So, yeah, Hellebuck, we're getting rid of him for a good defenseman. Let's propose the trade. It's going to go through. All right. Nice. And they also, just for reference, don't have a goalie right now. Their best goalie is 83. So that kind of makes sense for them. And let's do best roster again. And now, our defensemen, we have too many. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then Addison at 7. So I'm going to try to basically just move Addison so he's not in the AHL. And he doesn't really seem to be growing that much anyway. He is listed as a top 6 defender, but he doesn't really seem to be going anywhere in a hurry. So let's see. Skaters matching the block. I'm just going to try to find a team that we could trade him to. No, I'll probably find someone better. Addison, what about this team? You got anyone for me? I kind of want to trade him for another defenseman because we don't really have a lot of prospect defensemen right now. I mean, our defensive core is pretty young and very talented, but yeah, I'm trying to find a defenseman that is young, a prospect that some team is willing to part ways with. A lot of top 6 forwards. Those are definitely not hard to come by. Defensemen, though, on the other hand, yeah, maybe not as easy, especially because they're probably looking to add defensemen, so they're likely not looking to get rid of defensemen. Low top 4. No, that's not what I'm looking for. You got what I want? Nope. It's a low top 6. And medium top 4. There we go. Now we're talking. Okay, sure. The value is actually not in our favor, but let's try it anyway. And trade rejected. Not sufficient at all. Relax. Chill out. Okay, let's go to... Yeah, let's maybe... Is there anyone else here that we could just add in that we're not really using? Rozovic is up to 82 again. Like, what the heck? All right, who can we get rid of here? That's just in the AHL. Hagel, I don't really... We can get rid of Dzingel. That could work. Dzingel and Addison for this guy, because we're not really ever going to use him. He's just an AHL player. And trade rejected. All right. I see you. What if we add... Do I add a draft pick for this guy? Like a fourth rounder, maybe? No, I want to keep our draft picks. Okay, you know what? No. Nope, not happening. Next. You can't even really get a third round pick for this guy. Like, he is just not going. Yeah, even that's rejected. Holy, his value is so low right now. I don't know why. That makes no sense. Maybe we should just hang on to him. $2 million for 3 years. He can play in the AHL. I doubt he would, like, go down drastically. Yeah, maybe it's worth holding on to him for now. But I don't want to put him in the AHL, but we don't really have a choice. Okay, so let's go to edit lines for now. So we get that nice plus two on the first line with Raymond, Barzal, and Zibanejad. And then Olofsson, Reinhardt, Boss is a zero. Our third line, on the other hand. Oh, that works. Connor Brown can play fourth line. Yep, that doesn't bother me. And I'd rather play Lundestrom here. Yeah, that works for me. Cool. I'm down with that. Just curious. Oh, no, that's not going to work. Okay, they want Zibanejad to be on the first line so bad. But I mean, it does get the plus two, so I'm willing to accept that. And defense. All right, let's try to make this work a little bit here. Anything I can do to spice up that chemistry? Oh, wow. I don't want to play Kavanov on the fourth pair, though. Although it does get really good chemistry. I also don't want Sergachev here, really. What can we do? Addison, I definitely want on the last pair. I don't really mind playing Bouchard on the last pair. Oh, man, we have a lot of good defensemen, too. This is actually crazy. Who is scratched for us right now? We have Hag. No, absolutely not. Get in there. Yeah, Addison's coming out. Hag's going in. Oh, that gets a plus two. Oh, my word. Maybe we will just rock Sergachev on that last pair. That's not out of the question. And I kind of want to move Kavanov up. He's listed as a top four. And so is Bouchard. They're both 84 overall. But yeah, I'll allow him to play with Miro. Okay. Yeah, let's maybe do that. And in the AHL, okay, let's go to roster moves. And let's send down our defenseman. Sorry, Addison. I am apologizing profusely, but it's got to be done. All right, you can go down. Confirm. Sorry about that, but it's a business here, okay? I want to win hockey games. Let's go to the AHL, and it already did best line, so I'm going to have to sort of try to remember what I did last time. So I moved you up. Okay, let me deal with this. Give me a second, and we will, yeah, try to figure it out. I remember Musty was up here with these guys, so that was a plus one. Yeah, that was it. All right, so we should maybe try to pick up a goalie in free agency. There's probably a decent one there. And this is what our lines look like. So Suzuki, this will likely be his last year in the AHL, hopefully. But yeah, we've got Granlund here as well. Low elite, he's only 68, but he should grow medium top six. Danielson here and Strand just down there as well. The first line is basically prospect central. And if we go to our defense, we got Addison playing with Carrick and then the rest there as well. And yeah, so let's try to pick up a goalie maybe. In the NHL now we have DiPietro and we have Esteban Thiel. And then our lines look like this. That's a pretty solid team, if you ask me. On defense, we got that. All right, so the only thing I'm going to try to do is pick up a goaltender, free agency, and see if anyone is there. All right. Oh my, Victor Arvidsson, 84 overall, and he wants 2.1? That is whack. Nobody picked him up. A second line forward here for $2 million. Too bad we don't need that. Otherwise, I would absolutely capitalize on that. Okay, let's go to goalies and sort by potential. I like this guy already. He's only 23, 78 overall, medium fringe starter. He's listed as a minor starter. Yep, sold. Not even going to do a lot of research. Done. You're on the team. Thank you for coming out. All right. Let's sim to the regular season and decline. Alex Newhook. Oh, I want him, but he just doesn't fit on the team. I already looked at it, and trust me, it's just not going to work. I wanted it so bad, but no, it will not go. Okay, so let's actually stop the simulation, because one thing I wanted to do is view the contracts and see if we could try to get some people back. So Barzal's going to want a big bump. Oh, okay. We could maybe, is 10.25 too much of a cut? I guess we're going to find out. Anyone else we have to re-sign? McLeod, I'm probably going to let you walk after this year. I'm sorry, but yeah, Rozovic doesn't want to re-sign. And I wasn't really going to re-sign him either. Engvall, meh, he can be done in the offseason. Is there anybody else here? Goalies. Wait, no. Main roster. Okay. Doesn't matter there. And I guess, yeah, it's pretty much everything. Well, we can go to in the system. Yeah, no, we're okay. We are okay. Yep, it is time to add that goalie in first. I almost forgot to do that. And then we will hopefully re-sign our first line centerman. And yeah, the rest is history. We can go ahead and simulate the season. Actually, wait, Barzal already said yes, didn't he? And I just wasn't really paying attention because I was... Oh no, he said yes now though. All right, cool. 10.2 for Barzal. I will take that. Time to simulate the season. Here we go. I was kind of thinking too that maybe it might be worth getting rid of Reinhardt soon or next season because he is kind of getting up there. He's also making a lot of money. His contract is not cheap. So yeah, that's just something to consider. But we're not off to the strongest start here, to say the least. 7-7-0. Okay, there's a win. There's another win. Love to see it. 9-7-0. Shootout loss. I'll take points wherever we can get them. Edmonton Oilers dishing us a 4-1-L. There's a big win. Okay, you know what? I'm done with this. Stop sending me trades. Get out of here. Why would DiPietro be on the block? What is that? Maybe that's why we were doing so bad. Holy crap. Whoever makes this thing needs to be canned immediately. Get out of there. And let's continue simulating, shall we? Washington Capitals. There's a big win. We got the Golden Knights, who are going to take us down. A shootout loss to the Wild. Okay, so things are not going incredibly well so far, I must say. Definitely not what I expected. Thought we'd be doing a little bit better than this. All right, there's a big overtime win against the Avalanche. I'll take shootout losses and overtime losses wherever we can get them. A point is a point. Okay, we're swinging it back around here a little bit. 9-goal game from us there. That is a massive performance. All right, the Hammerheads are really starting to pull it together here. I say that as we lose 3 games in a row. But yeah, I guess Reinhardt could maybe be like some off-season trade that we could do. It's just not really going to be a long-term thing with him at this point because he's already going to be 30. I think his contract is just under $8 million. He is listed as a first-line forward, but it would also clear up room for some other players that we need to get some time. Okay, let's keep our trading block. Let's enter the deadline just to see who's available, although I do not plan on making any moves. Oh my word. Well, I can't, but that would have been nice. Okay, JT Miller's back on the block here. Wow, okay. Interesting, Dylan Larkin's on the block. Philip Forsberg. Newhook is still here. Like, our team's doing good, but you know what? Let me look at something here. Newhook, low value. He's 86 overall, listed as a second line forward. If I go to... They do want Reinhardt. This could work. 1-for-1. He's got 1 year left, Newhook. And Reinhardt has 6 years left, so that is a... Yeah, that's a big contract. Will the scheme fit work, though? That is the question. Do I have anything on that? He fits on the offensive line 3. Oh. He fits on forward line 2. Should we do it? Newhook for Reinhardt, 1-for-1. Get a younger player here, medium elite. Ah, let's try it. Trade accepted. Okay. Oh, it came out. Yeah, right. Don't think he came out on the short end there. Give me a break with all that. All right, so Newhook is now a part of our team. And that's it. I'm done. I'm tapping out. I don't want to make any more moves, but I do want to stop the sim so we can go put our lines together. And yeah, let's see. There is no blockbuster trades to tell me about. Is that what you're saying right now? Okay, the AHL team's doing amazing. Love that for them. Edit lines. Okay, let's see what we got here. So Newhook fits in with Boss and Olofsson nicely with a zero. And I had Lundestrom up here. Roslovic up here. Okay, so he does fit in. That's good. Yep, that'll work on defense. I think that we pretty much just left it. Is Kavanov listed as top four? Yeah, okay, I'm going to leave him then. And then maybe Hanifin is someone we could get rid of too to get like a more depth defenseman. Because he is currently making 7.8. Yeah, we could definitely dump that in the offseason. DiPietro, how's he doing? 916, he's doing very well. And then a 907 from Esteban. Let's go. Okay, goalies are performing. In the AHL, do we see any growth? Oh my goodness, it re-edited the lines. Are you kidding me? All right, give me a minute. This guy's already up to 79 as well. Still a minor starter, but that's good. Medium fringe. And he has a 909. This guy's not doing so good. Vinny, you gotta pick it up, dude. All right, so yeah, I re-edited the lines. They're pretty much where they were before, I think. Yeah, it looks good. Okay, and then the NHL. We've got Newhook, Olofsson, and Boss. And we have Zibanejad, Barzal, Raymond, Lundestrom, Thomas, Roslovic. Okay, our team is looking solid. Yep, looks good. Okay, let's finish off the season. We should make the lofts, I'm hoping. I'd be pretty shocked if we didn't, especially considering we already have 37 wins at the deadline. I mean, we did just get rid of Reinhardt. I wasn't even really sure how he was performing, but I just wanted to get rid of that contract. Lacroix is gone. Okay, here we go. Big win against Calgary. And back-to-back losses there, but we bounce back with a win against the Isles. A shutout victory against the Kraken. LA Kings will take it to overtime and lose, but that is fine. All right, big win there. We are second in the division right now. It's looking good. We are actually definitely in the race for winning the division, which is nice. No, the Golden Knights are kind of pulling ahead, and we are absolutely sucking right there. That's rough, but we're definitely in the playoffs, and we got the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim in round one. Okay, stop the simulation. Actually, let's go up to our first game here. Okay, nice. So we got the Anaheim Ducks in round number one. Yeah, how'd the AHL team do? They went 59 wins, 18 losses. Hagel got 3 points in the first playoff game. Absolute units down there. All right, well, let's have a look at some of the stats, shall we? So we got 46 wins on the year, which is good enough for third in the Pacific Division in the entire league. That puts us at eighth. So we finished on the first page. Yeah, I went one past first page, which is nice. And let's go down here. Is it top 16 that made it? Nope, we got the 18th placed Islanders making it in. Congrats. Okay, so that's the standings. And we got 85 points from Barzal. That's a little underwhelming. Boss put up 75, though, and he's at 88. Newhook ended up putting up 55, but we don't know how he was performing before. I guess we could look. He had... Oh, okay, yeah. He was 15 points in 19 games with us. That's pretty good. So, and a plus two. Yeah, so most of that was from his previous team. Lucas Raymond only put up 53. Huh. Interesting. Sergachev put up 47 and he was on the third pair. Zibanejad 46 on the first line. He didn't really grow. Robert Thomas is still 85, which is nice to see. Okay. Yeah, there we go. That is the points. I expected more from Barzal, but I think Zibanejad kind of held him back. I'm going to be honest. And Raymond didn't really do so well either. But, maybe we could move Boss back up to the first line. I think it gives the first and second line zero, but it might be worth it. Is Zibanejad still listed as third line? Okay. We might need to make a move there then. We might move him down to the third line for now. Goalies! Yeah, they did well. 40 wins for DiPietro, a 910 and 261. And then from Teal, we got a 916 and 239. He's still 82, still 85, but a good year nonetheless. And let us check out the entire league. So we've got Sebastian Aho with 118. What a unit. Holy crap. Svechnikov with 110. Shane Wright with 93. Attaboy. High Elite. He's still only 22. Nate Mack, 92. All right. So Sebastian Aho with the Art Ross. Who won the Rocket Richard? I guess McKinnon and Svech might share it. Nope. Matthews with 51. There he is. He just beat them out. Okay. Good for you. And let's check out defensemen, just to not leave them out of the mix. So we got Hughes with 76. No point a game defenseman this year. Oh, Miro Heiskanen put up 67. Let's go. He's up to 90 overall. I didn't really even notice him. That is huge. That is huge. All right, let's go, Miro. Love that out of you. He was a dash 5, though. But anyway, Makar was 65. And then we've got Fox, 63. Riley's there as well. All right. Ryan Merkley, he's got to be growing. Yep. Boakfist, what's he at now? He is an 88. McAvoy, 89. Okay, let's look at goaltenders. So we've got Anderson with 45. And he had a 923. Vasilevsky also had a 923. That is incredible. Vanecek is doing well as well, even though he's only 83. He's keeping up with 93, Vasilevsky. And I guess Freddie's down to an 84, but yeah, he still had a stellar year. All right, DiPietro's up there. He is up there, so he had a good year. Good stuff. Thatcher Demko up there as well. Okay, Dan Vladar. Nice. Good stuff. Let's have a look at the playoff tree just to see who's playing who. So there you go. That is the way it's shaped up. We have the Ducks in round one. And there is a line move I think I want to make, because that first line is not working and I want it to work. So if we move Boss up, and then we can move Robert Thomas up. And is there anyone here? You're listed as a centerman. There you go. We could try that out. Who's better on faceoff? 79, 72. All right, congrats. You're in the middle. And he shoots right. He shoots right. He's the only one that shoots left. Okay, we'll leave it like that. And then McLeod. Yep. Okay. Oh. I'm not going to do it. But yeah, Zibanejad is now on the third line. Okay, so there we go. We've got Boss, Barzal, and Raymond. Insane first line. Olofsson, Newhook, and Thomas. And then these guys down here. Yeah. Defense. Sergachev and Hag. That's probably why they did so good. I kind of want to move someone up, but did you see? That moves the bar up. It doesn't give them the plus one, but it's so close. But yeah, I'll leave Bouchard there for now because he is right-handed. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Alrighty. Looks good. Looks good indeed. Yep. Alright, well, we'll leave it. So yeah, it's time for the playoffs. It is time for the Year 5 playoffs. Hopefully you guys agree with some of the trades I made today. We got rid of some big contracts, brought in some new big contracts, but can I do it right now? Can you offer a contract extension during the playoffs? I guess maybe. Why not? He doesn't want an extension. You absolute... Oh. My word. Okay, well, that sucks. That is unfortunate, to say the least. Yep. Anyway, I'll wait till the offseason for you. And yeah, we have a very similar record to the Ducks here. Incredibly similar. They finished off the year better than us, but I'll see you guys in the next video.